Our next speaker was the very first community manager at Danone. How many people here know what a community manager is? Okay, I see some hands, right? I'm sure you will learn a lot more now, but we need to go beyond just community management in terms of how we manage the people with whom we interact. We need to go into gardening. Here is one of France's leading community gardeners, Monsieur Olivier Morel.
Alors, nous allons parler de community management. Quand nous parlons de community management,
when we talk about community management, of course, we think about communities, networks, social networks.
Voilà quelques logos.
These are a few logos, more or less known.
Chacun de ces logos est
each logo
un ticket pour voyager.
Is a ticket to travel.
Alors, je vous propose qu'on
so,
se lève pour voyager.
Let's stand up and let's travel.
Prenez le ticket que vous voulez.
Take the ticket you want, the network you want.
Qui vous intéresse le network dans lequel vous êtes.
What interests you, the one in which you are most at ease, where you feel most at ease.
Et nous allons
and we're going to travel.
Décoller.
We're going to take off.
Est-ce que nous oserions sauter sur jusqu'à des grands espaces?
Have we moved to high spaces, a little jump to continue? Let's have a little jump. Come on, jump, jump, come on, jump. Now, the great spaces, well, that could be California, or where many of the social networks have been invented. And yet, what I invite you to do now, we'll do a more inner trip.
Merci, vous pouvez vous
now, sit down. Rasseoir. It's okay. You've been good.
Vous pouvez vous rasseoir et continuer la connexion avec,
continue the connection with a specific space, an inner space, where
your
childhood, you as a child, this is Olivier, this is me, says he.
Un peu plus de, il y a 25 ans.
About 25 years ago.
Pas tout à fait l'âge de raison.
I was not yet an adolescent, but and I was already full of love.
It's his parents who loved him as any good loving parent, attentive parent. They wanted to say to him that it was great that he was around. Just, you know, the simple fact that he was alive. He was continuing, you know, the wonderful journey of life that we were reminded by Fernandel in the little film we just saw. So this is what they wanted to say to him, but as you know, any parent, what is it that they were saying to Olivier? Well, to continue, you know, being the fantastic promise we see in you, do your homework, tie up your shoelaces, you know, finish your plate, go to bed. And what did Olivier hear behind all of these words? He heard that there was actually a conditional love. I love you if you do things right. If you go to bed when I tell you to, if you do your homework.
Bien faire les choses.
So do things right.
Un conditionnement parfaitement intégré.
So totally integrated conditioning system.
Je grandis dans mon rapport à l'autre.
So you know, again, I grow in my relationship to others if I do things right. And if you do it, if you look at it from a collective fashion,
faire des choses,
we all
bien.
Try to do things right.
Si bien,
and we do them so well that our productivity
accrue. De manière
it has
exponential.
Increased in an exponential manner.
Quel voyage si nous regardons la
manière dont nous produisons. You know, we've come a long way if we see the way we produce goods, services over the last 10 years, you know, how we've increased our production capacity. Amazing. And mostly for the good of humanity. We've integrated the fact that we all have, you know, whatever way we do it, we have something to do here. So our relationship to the world is to do. And just as well.
C'est assis sur une représentation
so this
monde,
is a representation, a linear representation of the world where we, you know, cut up our activities, you know, step by step. And on each link of this value chain, we have things to do, a bit like the little Shadrach, you know, we do, we move around, we gesticulate, and this value chain is based on seven beliefs. Seven beliefs that were very useful to build the modern industrial world as we know it. And I would describe, belief in growth, infinite growth, competition, values of competition, effort, the value of concentration,
sens de la carrière,
the sense of career, consumption, consolation, and values of conformity. As you hear me speak, you can feel, the doubts I have, and also, and if they've been very useful, these beliefs to reach the state of advancement, we've reached today, they are actually showing up some limits on the theme of growth. So I know that we have perfume and cosmetic experts here, and correct me if I'm wrong, but it's not because I'm going to add a bit of lipstick or a bit of perfume that I'm going to smell better or be more beautiful. You know, the more, accumulating things is not equal to the development of a being or of success. So now, as regards concentration, another C. Why should pain, concentration, provide me with something better through pain? Aren't the things that are beautiful that don't require an effort? Let's talk about career. It's true that 150 years ago, I mean, people, didn't. Weren't concerned about career, but when you think of your life today, you tend to think of what it is you're going to do in 2 years, 3 years, 5 years down the road. And our first contact with the unknown is and you, what do you do for a job? What do you do in your life? What's your social status? What's the little pigeonhole you fill? So, consumption, we know in this, again, we know the problems with excessive consumption. I'd like to talk about mass consolation. What are our ads and, what are they saying to the world? Will I be happier? I have a big car, a big bottle of perfume, or a big pot of yogurt? Will I be happier? What are the ads trying to console in us, to cheer up in us? So conformism or conformity? Does one have to always follow the others? In the word conformism or conformity, there's the word comfort. How far must I go? And actual comfort, does it tie me up or does it free me? Is it when I have three, four screens, connected objects, do I feel freer or do I feel more imprisoned? And can't you have comfort with less sobriety, lightening up things? Less of, instead of more of. So this system of beliefs has grown over the years, and there's been definite advantages to these beliefs, but perhaps today we're somewhat asphyxiated, a little bit as if we were a frog, put in a pot of water, we put it over the fire, and the water was cold, and the temperature has increased, and we felt better, but, by increasing the heat, the frog doesn't realize that it's going to end up cooked. So this system, this value system, is perhaps gobbling us up. Worse, in this society of mass consumption, where in all these shelves with umpteen numbers of consumer goods. So an element of freedom is an element of imprisonment. So in fact, we're like in a prison where we've become phantoms, ghosts, and we are no longer human beings. We are consumers. We become consumers behind bars for some of us.
Alors qu'est-ce qu'on dit au
Okay. Here's Oliver. What do we say to the child inside of me or to your own children? Is that the end of the story? Is that it? The age of the doing. to do? I mean, industrial society, it stops right here and now.
Alors, je me suis posé des questions sur cette chaîne de valeur.
So I asked myself questions about this value chain.
Les maillons de cette chaîne,
about the different links, connections. So it's like in over the last 10 years, I've been on a path.
Bien sûr, en parlant de
community management, of course, you know, when we talk of community management and social network, I could have talked about best practices, networks, but, you know, again,
y a des éléments qui doivent rester secrets.
There are certain things that have to remain secret.
Pour vous inviter à les vivre, mais, et les faire vivre à vos enfants intérieurs.
You know, to actually have them speak to the child inside of you. So again, what can we learn? So one starting point.
La richesse de demain,
so,
c'est
you know, the wealth of tomorrow
on en a parlé.
Will be made up of our relationships. And back to what Claudie was saying, the ancestral wisdom confirmed this. I was lucky, you know, to meet the Amerindian culture, and it stays in my heart, Mitakuye Oyasin. Mitakuye Oyasin.
À toutes mes relations.
To all my relations. You know, I bless our interdependence to all our relations.
Moins loin de nous.
So not far from here.
Sous les dessins d'Éric, la pensée de Albert Jacquard.
This is Albert Jacquard's thought here, who left us very recently.
Je suis le lien que je tisse
I am the link
avec les autres.
That I weave with others.
Alors précisément, moi, ça m'a invité à passer de mon costume de l'ancien monde.
Me want to, you know, leave, you know, my suit from business school. I did a, you know, I've been involved in mergers and acquisitions. You know, I was right in the center of the values of the old world,
the world of money,
and I moved in the direction of what could be the DNA of the values of the new world, the links, the relationships, the communities.
Qu'est-ce que je retiens de ce voyage?
So,
bien sûr, je pourrais passer par des chiffres.
So I could give numbers. I mean, I've been working on with communities for 5 years.
L'animation I worked pour le social business,
on
for
a new capitalism, and I was actually lucky to be working with Mr. Younes, Nobel Prize of 2006, and I've been working on the internet. I found 5,000 investors who paid 70 million euros for a projects with a high social return. I participated in nine events. I participated 7 times to World Social Forum. I could give you all these numbers.
À un moment, les chiffres
so,
ne font pas le point.
But, you know, again, at one point in time,
ce qui compte
numbers
vraiment,
don't mean anything anymore. And what really counts, you can't measure.
Et j'évoquerai donc seulement la mosaïque de portraits des personnes
the mosaic of the people I was lucky enough to meet.
Voilà une mosaïque
so
de
this
visages.
Is a mosaic
voilà
of faces.
La trame de qui je suis.
This is who I am, in
alors
fact.
Envie de Marc,
I'd like to talk
Marie
to you about Lorraine, Mark, Marie-Lorraine, Philip,
Han, de Patrick, de Frédéric,
Patrick, Frédéric, Emmanuel, Pierre, Dominic.
C'est un peu eux à travers
so it's, you know, it's these people through me that are here today in a certain way.
Dans mon rapport à eux,
in my rapport
dans mes relations
to them,
eux,
my relationship with them,
quatre
there's been four
ingrédients.
New ingredients.
L'authenticité, la
authenticity, co-creation, transmutation, and coincidences.
L'authenticité, c'est
authenticity
mon choix
is my choice at a given moment
in
time to reconcile my
professional
environment, my professional requirements, and my own requirements, and to conjugate them in the same tense, and to try and find an integrity, which means that, you know, what I do and what I say is in line with one another, that there's no
this,
again, the two work in the same direction, or moving in the same direction.
Forme de verticalité,
and there's a sort of verticality in this congruence.
À cet axe vertical,
so there's the vertical axis, and there is a horizontal axis, my relations, my relationships, the way I co-create with others.
C'est pas je fais avec, hein.
It's not I do
c'est pas
with. It's not juxtaposition.
Non,
no, I co-create with.
participons, nous sommes
and we participate, we are here to serve something that is well beyond us, that connects us. And you're not looking at whether everything fits like a puzzle. No, it's, you know, how do we move ahead in order to participate to a story that's well beyond any one of us? And then there's this... transmutation that has to do with time, to allow time to act within us. I've participated in many projects. I mean, some flourished, others crashed. Have actually biodegraded themselves. And the humus process that we can see in life, it's difficult to accept it, you know, when you are a project leader. Things aren't working out as I was hoping they would. Oops, it's rotting. You know, from this rotting or deterioration, something can be born again. It's thanks to mud that the lotus appears.
When
one participates in a conference on innovation, sometimes I felt frustrated and I said, you know, so what? You know, so, you know, what can we actually use? A bit like I could take a product on the shelves in the supermarket and, okay, I've got it, I don't have it, or, you know, I didn't have it, I have it now. You don't have these automatic reactions anymore when you talk about the transformations that we're looking at. You know, let time act within us. Give time to time, basically. And I think it's also important for me to keep an eye on coincidences. You know, again on these the right notes in life's symphony. You know. So, am I aware? Am I being careful, vigilant, to realize that life, you know, beyond you know what I'd planned, comes knocking on my door to give me good news and to open the path.
Alors quoi?
So what?
Eh ben alors, aujourd'hui, c'est pour partager.
So I'm here today to share a dream. I could have shared knowledge, know-how on community management, but so I think what I need, what we need, what the world need, are not knowledge but dream.
Dreams. De création de nouveaux espaces
and to create a new for us to create. When I talk about TAS, I'm talking about temporary autonomous zones where we can experience other ways of living, other ways of being a society. And today, versus what's at stake today and the challenges ahead of us, I believe it is necessary to start dreaming once again. And where, you know, we have limited knowledge, our power of imagination actually spills out over the world.
Alors mon rêve, ce serait quoi?
So my dream, what is it? To create a villa of recreation, temporarily, perhaps just for a summer, sort of a Médicis villa, the Villa Médicis in Rome, has been a fantastic venue for the Renaissance, so that the artists at the time were able to go there and paint, repaint the world, the Villa Médicis. So the artists of the world of the future, the craftsmen and craftswomen of the world of the future, might they not find a lot of pleasure in meeting, getting together for a summer to slow down, decelerate.
Pour ralentir.
Yes, to slow down. And to slow down what for? To create. Through sharing,
autour de leur rêve, de
you know, again, around
de
you know, their dreams, their visions of the world of the future.
Pourquoi est-ce que je viens à Grasse pour,
am I here in Grasse to talk about this ephemeral villa of recreation? Because I need your help. Because I feel that, you know, here in this room, you would have understood that after, you know, the age of doing and thinking, we are now moving slowly into the age of the sensitive. So as a perfumer, as perfumers, you have the art and you know the art and subtlety of combinations and associations. You know how to identify what is essential because you know how to go and find in nature what are the most, the rarest and richest extracts. Because you know everything is done, you know, in under open skies. Because you have a very precise sense of the weaker signals. Because you have the sense of the nuances, and because you're and again, your work is very close to mysterious revelations. Or stop on mysterious missions. I think you can inspire the world through these qualities that you possess. So the sense of nuance, I think it's important to bring it to the forefront. So you know how to detect. Today, wealth. It's a monolithic block that's at a national level based on indicators such as the GDP. And through our activities, we're no longer able to understand what contributes positively and what contributes negatively.
Il y a des nuances.
And there are nuances.
Ce n'est pas normal.
So it's not normal
accidents sur la route
that road accidents increase. That they increase statistically our wealth.
Sur la question des,
so
des métiers,
on the issue of professional activities, I think this word is much
emploi,
more rich
travail.
Than, you know, work, job.
Je crois plus à l'emploi pour tous.
I don't believe in a job for everyone.
Chacun.
I believe the word métier
vient du 12e siècle.
It comes from the 12th century.
La même racine
it has the same root
mystère et
as
ministère.
Ministry and mystery.
En fait, ça date
in
du
fact,
ou un compagnon
so in the past there was a companion who would actually entrust a mission to his apprentice, a mysterious mission to his apprentice, an artistic technique, a know-how that he would be able to make his own or her own, and that would evolve.
Eh bien, je pense que
so I believe that you know, the world of tomorrow
appellera
will
actually
bring into play new métiers, new mysterious missions. And as artist, as a craftsman of perfumes and cosmetics, you're already accustomed to practice these new types of know-how. And it's important to share with others and to open up this villa for recreation. So if we want to launch this in the summer of 2014,
il nous reste plus qu'à
well,
où est-ce qu'on a envie de la mettre?
So where do we want to position it? Thank you.
Il y en a eu des chiffres. Mais là,
God, we got figures. There we go.
We have some more excellent illustrations. Ah, une carrière, c'est un trou. Ah bah. Well, what we see here is not only what we can do within our industries to be moving forward and managing our communities and thinking about different ways of approaching life, but also how this community can actually lead and influence others. So I do encourage you, if you think that you will be interested in recreating the future, go and talk to Olivier afterwards. I'm sure he'd love to hear from you. Now, one of the things Olivier said is that a lot of the social networks, which he mentioned at the beginning, come from the Bay Area, from San Francisco. However, not all of these social media innovations are actually done by Americans.